Now we will discuss the hydrogen atom, and inside it we will discuss the orbits and the orbitals. So we will only focus on the first three orbits, and inside that orbit we will focus on the s orbital only, because we know that when l is equal to 0, then we have no dependence of the wave function on theta and phi. So we don't have any angular dependence, and all the dependence is on the radial wave function, and the radial wave function we are having R and L. So this psi 1 is means that it is R10. Similarly, psi 2 is means when we will have the second orbit, then we will have n equal to 2 and l equal to 0, and similarly here n equal to 3 and l equal to 0. So the three orbits that we are focusing, the principal three orbits 1, 2, and 3, then inside that orbit we are focusing on the s orbital. So s is here l equal to 0, l equal to 0, and l equal to 0. So this is actually that we are having psi 1 0 0 here, and psi 2 0 0 here, and psi 3 0 0 here. So I will plot their probabilities, I will plot their wave functions as well as their probabilities. Now the very first one that I am going to plot is psi 1 0 0. Now 1 over pi a cube is a constant, where a is the Bohr radius, and this is exponentially decaying function. It is the same as I write this thing is R10. So n is 1 and l is 0. When l is 0, then the ml here and the psi will be 0 as well. So the plot of it is like this, that it starts from some value, although it is not touching it, because here I see that when R is equal to 0, then we are having this one 0, and only 1 over pi a cube is the value. So this is going like a decaying function, and it goes like this. So our wave function is a decaying wave function, which remains positive, and this is R. We can differentiate this one in terms of the Bohr radius, but for this one is just a decaying function. And if I plot the probability of this wave function, then the probability will be starting from here, from 0, and going very sharp, means close to this one, and then back here and decaying like this. So here we will have to understand one thing, and that is that here our radial wave function, our wave function, because it is having no angular dependence, we are considering the s orbits only, orbitals only, which are spherically symmetric. Here at r equal to 0, we are having the maximum value of our function, while the value decreases as we increase r, and it goes to 0 at r equal to infinity, r means going very close to 0. But here, is the probability is actually r square times r nl, means r square times r square nl. Now this probability, at r, when r is equal to 0, we are having the probability is 0, and the probability increases as I reach a value, that is, means at this value I have the maximum probability, and this value is actually equal to our A, which is our Bohr radius. Like here I can see that when this value of when R is equal to A, then we will have A over A in e to the power minus 1, which will become 1 over E, and 1 over E is the maximum value in this result, while later it will decrease. As this will grow than this one, then what will happen, that R will be, means the negative value of this will be more, and it will be divided by more that value. Like this, I can write this one a constant, which is 1 over pi a cube here, and e r over a. When r will be equal to 0, then we will have the e power 0 is 1, and it will be just c here at this value. Now when I come to the probability, then the probability means this term will be squared, so it will be minus 2 r over a and 1 over pi cube. But the starting point here is 0 due to the reason that r square is multiplied here, and it reaches the maximum when r is equal to a. Here it will be 2r in case of probability 2r over a. When the r is equal to a, we will have maximum probability, and if we further increase r, then this r is increasing, but the RNL is actually decreasing, because the RNL is the exponential decay here, and we are having a decrease in this. When I go to the next, and the next is psi 2s. So here now it will become clear about the radius as well. And if I plot this psi 2s, then it will be, means compared to this one, let me extend this a little bit more, and now what we will have, that we will have from here, we will have a decaying function, and a function will be decaying, and it will go like this. And after this one, because now I am plotting this one, here I am having 2 minus r over a, 1 r is coming in here, and e to the power minus r over 2a. So this will cause a bit negative portion in this, and then it will go like this. So we will have a negative portion, and then our wave function will become like this. Now here, why this one? What is this value? This value is actually 2 times the Bohr radius. Look here. Look at this equation. Now the equation is a constant, then a constant. We will focus on R and A here. So what will be the result here? When R is less than A, means this portion. So here, If this is 2a, then this is the value r, this is a, and this is 2a. So look here, when r is equal to a, then this value is 2 minus 1. So we will have 2 minus 1, 1. So only the constant survives here, and this becomes 1. Here, it will be e minus r over 2a, so a will cancel, it will become e minus half. When this is e minus half, then this is part of a decaying function, means the exponential is yet decaying. But when we have r equal to 2a, then here r is 2a and it cancels in, again it comes out to be the magnitude, which will be the maximum magnitude here, and it is 1 over e. What will be here? This is 2a, a will cancel, and 2 minus 2 will become 0. So we will touch 0 at r equal to 2a. And now, when we come here at this point, then what will happen? That when r will grow more than a, means when r becomes 3a, for example, so a will cancel in 2 minus something greater than 2, so this result will become negative here. This is a decaying situation, but here the result will become negative and our wave function will go, our radial wave function, our wave function of our s orbital will go negative. Now, why it starts becoming positive again? So, look here. Here, whatever value of r now I will put, when it will become greater than 2a, then the result will be negative here. But look here, when r is equal to 2a, then a cancels and we are having e minus 1. Now, when r is greater than 2a, what will happen? That for r greater than 2a, we will have the change here, and the change is that, let's say this is 3a, we calculated this one at 3a, so the negative portion is there, and when it goes, means the maximum is coming here, put r equal to 3a, a will cancel, and now it will become 3 over 2. So look at this one, that when e is minus 1, this was the maximum value, and now e will become, for 3a will become minus 3 over 2, means greater than 1 here when r is equal to 3a. So 3 over 2, then again it will become 5 over 2, for example, as I go on, but I will have to look here to this value as well. And this value I see when it is 3a, then 2 minus 3 will become minus 1. So here I am having minus 1, and here I am having e to the power minus 3 by 2. Let me go to some higher value, and the higher value, let's say for r equals 5. Now, when r is equal to 5 times a, then what will be here? 2 minus 5. So it will become minus 3. So minus 3 here. So when r is 3a, we are having 3 by 2. So as I go on from 2a, then it is decreasing, but in 2a it is minus 1. and then it grows from minus 1, means this is 1.5. As it is on the negative side, means from here we are having now onward for R, for all values of R, we will have this result is negative, so we will remain on the negative side. But at 3a when it reaches, then the exponential starts growing, and here this growth is here, and it will go on more and more growing, and as R will go more and more, this growth flattens here with this, and we are having our wave function like this. For example, at R equal to 5a, we will have 5 by 2, and 5 by 2 is 2.5. So the exponential is growing, but as the result will remain on the negative side, then we will have, means when it is the 2s, so we will have our wave function like this. And if I do like the find the probability here, so keeping in view that R square multiplication, and it is the same, this portion is the same, so we will have our probability like this, that is we got probability for this. So this was here, it will be somehow like this. This will be the probability, and for this portion, while this portion means the more higher R values, we will have very high probability here, and then it will decrease. Let me extend this more, and this shows that now the maximum probability is here, means the electron is in the second orbit of the s orbital here.